morning, everybody, and you're welcome to another time of MFC 365. This is where we pray daily, every day from 12 a.m. to 1 a.m. We are starting off our day with prayers, and today is day 228 on our MFC program, and today our prayer focus is God will establish me in the name. Starting off today's prayers by the Spirit of God, and we are thanking God. We are entering His presence with thanksgiving on our lips. We are thanking God from the depth of our heart for what God has done for us in the past days, the past weeks, the past months, the past years. We are exalting the name of the Lord because He has been good to us. Bible says in Psalm 147 verse 7, sing to the Lord with thanksgiving, sing praises with the harp and with lyre to our God. Let us give thanks to Him. Let us rejoice before Him. Let us make melodies to our God. He is
Thank you.
Second segment on our prayers. Today we are praying for our nation Nigeria and we are praying for our local assembly. This affords us a wonderful opportunity to mention Nigeria before God every day and our local assembly. Join me as we do that. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 11, "For no other foundation can anyone lay than that which has been laid, which is Jesus Christ, the Messiah and the Anointed One." We will be praying. Alabusha Kataya for our local assembly. Anenusa Katayada, that no other foundation will be laid in our
Era Shalom,
The segment we are praying for our finances, Kenusa Elepashaka. It is good to pray for our finances because while we are still on this earth, we need money. Money answers all things, and we need to pray for our finances. The Bible says in Psalm 128 and verse 2, "For you shall eat the fruit of the labor of your hands. Happy, blessed, fortunate, enviable shall you be, and it shall be well with you in the name of Jesus." Let's begin to pray this prayer in the name of Jesus, that we will eat the labor of our hands in the name of Jesus. We will not labor for another to eat in the name of Jesus. God will bless you.
Shalom,
Hallelujah. And the Katala Kabaya Kataya. We have come to the segment where we lift up a prayer incense before God to pray for our families. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 128 and verse 3, your wife will be like a fruitful vine in the innermost part of your house, your children like olive plants round about your table. This is a blessing God Himself is pronouncing on the family. That our wives, the women, the mothers will be fruitful in the name of Jesus, and our children will be blessed in the name of Jesus.
Shalom,
Into the name of the Lord, this is the segment where we make warfare before God. And let us be focused in this prayer because it is time for warfare. The Bible says in Psalm 127 verse 1, except the Lord builds the house, they that build labor in vain. Except the Lord keeps the city, the watchman watches are put in vain. Let us begin to pray. That the Lord himself will build our home, will build our families, will build our churches, and will build our nation in the name of Jesus. That our labor will not be in vain. Go ahead, turn it.
Shut up,
In this segment, we are praying our desires, whatever it is we are believing God for, we are trusting God for, whatever it is that is a desire in our hearts, we are bringing it to God in prayers. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 7 and verse 7, it reads, keep on asking and it will be given to you. Amen. That is the reason why we come here every 12 a.m. and keep on asking and keep on praying, because the scripture says we should keep on asking and it will be given us. Keep on seeking and you will find. Keep on knocking reverently and the door will be open to you. Let us go ahead.
Shalom,
We are making Psalm 91 declaration. We are not tired of making Psalm 91, declaring Psalm 91 for the protection of our lives, our children, our spouse, our relatives, in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in Psalm 91 and verse 7, 1,000 shall fall at our side, 10,000 at our right hand, but it will not come near us.
Everybody in the world,
We have come to the segment where we make the blood declaration. We put the blood of Jesus upon our lips and we begin to sprinkle that blood upon ourselves, upon everything we have, upon our home, in our workplace, our assembly, our children, our husbands, in the name of Jesus. Says in John 6 and verse 56, it says, he who feeds on my flesh and drinks my blood dwells continually in me and I in him. In like manner, continually dwells in him. Go ahead, pray. And if you have a communion emblem, this is the right time to take it in the name of God.
Everybody in the world, 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 everybody in the world
To the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we are still praying, and now we are praying the Pauline prayers. Glory be to the name of the Lord. The Bible says in the book of Ephesians, chapter 1 and verse 17, for I always pray for you that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may grant unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation, the insight into mysteries and secrets, and the deep and intimate knowledge of God. Go ahead, begin to pray this. Pray it with everything you have. Pray. The spirit of wisdom, revelation, eyes of our understanding, enlightened in the name of
Everybody,
Come to the segment where we pray and ask God for healing, healing in our bodies. Akatusa kataya, elekara basha kataya. The devil is a liar. We will not experience sickness. Diseases are not our portion. In the name of Jesus, we have healthy bodies, healthy brains, healthy minds. In the name of Jesus. Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 6 and verse 19, and all the multitudes were seeking to touch him, for healing power was all the while going forth from him and curing them all, saving them from severe illnesses and calamities. Turn it into prayers. Satana, We have come to the last segment in today's prayers. Glory to God. And in this last segment, we are praying for mercy and the favor of the Lord to rest upon our heads. Ikanusha katala gabana mashakata elebushu makata yiga elebana ba. Bible says in Exodus 20:6, but showing mercy and steadfast love to the thousandth generation of those who love him and keep his commandment. That is the word of the Lord, that he shows mercy, he shows steadfast love. Father, we thank you.
Shalom,
Jesus, I declare that today